I've stewed on and given this analogy on a handful of accounts, and I think it's time to commit to sharing it with a larger audience. This is my UX wheel analogy. Analogy or metaphor, I think it's an analogy, but admittedly, I spent way too much time trying to Google the difference between the two, and after all that, I'm still not entirely convinced. I'm gonna go with analogy. With the training and skill set we have as UX designers, I found that we can be the best suited individuals at a company to allow thoughts and ideas to channel through. For better or worse, and we're gonna say better, many people at the company you work for or the client you service are gonna have ideas on how to carry forward a project. These ideas are gonna come at you from all angles. Get comfortable with this. You sit at the hub of a large wheel, and all these individuals are spokes of that wheel. You'll get input from executives, directors, product managers, developers, customers, advertisers, partners, and the list goes on. These different spokes have value in the process. Allow them to contribute. When you're sorting through the feedback, it's still your job to make sure the wheel rolls forward together. As a UX designer, it's your job to sit at the center of this information. You process and organize. You sift through the ideas and figure out the higher value ones over the others. You do this sifting based off of problem statements you're solving for, and obviously protecting both sides of business and the end user. Keep everyone on the same page. Keep everyone's feelings and thoughts validated. We can't just let an executive bull forward an idea just because they pay your paycheck. And we can't let a developer have the final say because at the end, the developer has to build it anyways. We, as the hub of the wheel, need to keep the team working together. We need to defend both sides of the coin and maintain balance in the process. We need to take people on the journey together. And in the end, you might have to sell an idea to someone who isn't quite on board if it's the right decision. Now, there's a lot to this. The right decision should be based off of testing, iteration, etc. But at the end of all that, you might not have someone bought in yet. To keep the wheel balanced, you need to help people get on board. All of these people are contributing with good intentions. Let's not allow personal bias to throw off the balance of your wheel. If you focus on this idea that all input is a spoke in the wheel, and you're trying to keep the wheel in balance, your teams will work more effectively, and in the end, the product will be something everyone can buy into. If you enjoyed this rant, then consider giving Design Today a subscribe. New episodes every Tuesday.